state of play is really clear, right? AI models have become commoditized. Compute costs have come down. But the bottleneck, as you see it and many others see it, is the data. You have a solution.
Yes. As you just wanted to put that into context again, because now, you know, the previous generation of models were scraping the internet's data, which is, you know, you can scrape it all. But now AI is going to the physical world. It's the multi-model models, right? It's a robotics model. It's a video model, audio model. And the really real bottleneck is the data, as you said, because, you know, you can't now scrape it illegally on the internet. And a lot of times this data is very private. You know, it's a lot of IP safety concerns. And in that world, how do you coordinate the collection, labeling, curating of the data? And we are using actually crypto incentives to actually coordinate that massive labor coordination.
So my next question was, why is Andreessen's crypto team backing you and not an AI specialist partner or a different firm?
First of all, my co-founder is a robotics at the UT Austin, and he's a big AI specialist who's been kind of working on this data licensing and data collection for the last 10 years. And even he thought about how do you incentivize data collection with data dividends. So, you know, he is an AI expert in this realm. But the reason why we are kind of we think this is so timely is, you know, 40 days ago, actually, Meta semi-acquired, actually, as you know, scale AI.
Right.
And that left a very huge vacuum in the space to actually for competitors and new players to come in. And if you look at scale AI, I mean, I'm not trying to criticize, but they had to, you know, make a lot of shell companies, work with shell companies in developing countries to actually coordinate this kind of digital sweatshop to make that happen. But the beauty of crypto is that it's still really good at coordinating incentives at a global scale and pay them instantaneously with stable coins or other type of crypto tokens, right? And that is a very, very huge advantage, number one, right? And number two, not only that, what crypto and blockchain does is it is good at, you know, putting this data and IP on an immutable ledger and track and attribute it and license it with smart contracts. And those two are very, very important advantages of crypto, even where my co-founder, AI specialist, wants to actually use this technology.
That's why, let's just go to the basics of the data that is needed here. I can see the crypto read across. I think of Axi Infinity, the game that went bananas in the Philippines years ago, how people wanted to play because they earned money and tokens via playing this crypto native game. You're going to use people, incentivize people to sort of video themselves in the real world that then ultimately helps Tesla build Optimus in the real world?
Yes, actually. You hit on the right comparable. Axi Infinity was an example of coordinating this massive number of people in the Philippines and other types of developing countries, other developing countries, to actually play games to earn tokens, right? In the same way, now, you know, when Tesla wants to train his humanoid robot, even if you scrape the entire internet's data, you can't actually have a Tesla robot holding a coffee cup, right? Because, you know, you need a million angles of data, egocentric video footage in a million different types of settings. And that kind of data, instead of actually hiring a shell company and having the shell company hire, you know, tens of thousands of people, you can coordinate this at a mass scale and instantaneously with crypto incentive. That's what we're doing.
And let's talk about the end demand here. How many companies, who is your ultimate provider? How do you then sell this IP safe AI training data?
Yeah, the reason why it's IP safe is that everyone who are actually contributing data, anyone can contribute this data anywhere around the world, right? And then actually set their licensing usage terms on the blockchain. And we are, at the moment, we're now completely decentralized, and we are now going to launch a decentralized DPIN app, a decentralized physical infrastructure app in fall, that actually collects data, you know, puts this on the blockchain with the licensing terms in place. But at the moment, we're now actually acting as an agent to actually secure these contracts. And we already have we've already signed a contract, and we cannot disclose it at the moment.
Right.
You know, and then if, I mean, in the robotics realm.
Well, quickly, yes, if scale AI, the scenario left a vacuum, and you look to occupy that vacuum, how many phone calls have you had from the other frontier model makers that you could fit into their organization in the same way? Just 30 seconds.
you know, actually many organizations, and I was really surprised the C-stage company, they were willing to work with us, because a lot of them were telling us that they were dropping contracts from Scale AI.
But I meant in terms of you being acquired or you joining a bigger group.
We don't have any plan. We don't have any plan, and we think
right.
The advantage of this open system is that we can work with any AI partners.